quit that.
Thank you very much. Our attendance today, we will now start our committee meetings. But first, we have a couple of appointments on various boards. First, Board of Appeals, Assessment Appeals, George Arrakis.
Mr. Chairman, I waive the rules. Nominating elect, Mr. George Arrakis.
Motion.
Second.
Second. Any other discussion? All in favor, raise your right hand. All opposed, it passes. Thank you. Spartanburg County, you want to vote for appeals?
Mr. Chairman, I'd like to waive the rules. Nominating elect, Bob A. Rowe.
Motion is second on Bob Rowe. Any other discussion? All in favor, raise your right hand. All opposed, it passes. Thank you. Next, we will move to our committee meetings. First, Economic Improvement and Development. David Britt, Chairman. Malcolm Brown, Jane Hall, Member. Mr. Britt.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. We've got three items before us. The first is the request to render first readings of ordinance for Project 2011A. This is an application for infrastructure credit to fee in lieu of tax payments and authorizing and approving matters relating thereto. Do I hear a motion that we approve on first reading?
So moved.
Motion's been made. Okay.
Second.
Second. All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Motion carries. We'll recommend to the council. Second item before us is to render first reading to an ordinance in relation to the Eaton Corporation. This is to enlarge the county industrial park in Spartanburg and Cherokee County. Do I hear a motion that we enlarge the park?
So moved.
Second.
Motion made and second. All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Motion carries. We'll recommend to the full council. The last item, we have a report from Mr. Chip Bentley, South Carolina Cog. Mr. Bentley, I'd like to make a presentation. Your presentation.
Yes, I appreciate you having me here today. And as we come back every year, we provide y'all with an update on the Comprehensive Economic Development Strategy for the Upstate, or the SEDS document, as we refer to it. Just give you a quick overview. SEDS is a document that's mandated by the Economic Development Administration for all local development districts throughout the country. It's a tool that they use to help support and guide economic decisions that they make at the local level from the federal agency when they're doing grant decisions. EDA is a federal agency under the Department of Commerce, and they provide grant help to communities to help support, to attract industry, encourage business development, and support efforts that will create long-term job growth for local communities. Their eligible activities range from water and sewer projects to access roads to industrial sites to business incubators, a lot of different projects, also workforce development with the tech schools that will directly relate to attracting jobs at that time. So typically it has to be related to either an industry that's located and needs a training program or an industry that's coming in and needs access to water, sewer, roads, things like that. Locally, the focus has always been on infrastructure and workforce development programs. The last EDA project, I believe, here in Spartanburg County itself was providing money to the health and sciences building at Spartanburg Community College several years ago. Also helped with some of the expansions of improvements at Wofford College to attract the Panthers training camp facility. They typically provide gap funding for projects. The example I always give is they'll put in about $1 million to a $10 million project if they know it's going to create 100, 150 jobs or so or something like that. They can provide up to $1.5 million in funding and can fund up to 50% of a project. They typically don't participate in that large percentage of it. They typically are a smaller player. But the document itself is required by EDA, and it's important primarily because in order to be eligible for Economic Administration funds, your project needs to be identified in that plan before they'll consider your application. So that's sort of the trigger here for doing this. The plan's a five-year plan. We adopted it in 2007. The Appalachian Council of Governments is a designated development district for this region. The document's really a compilation of economic development efforts from wide range of agencies in the upstate. We don't try and recreate the wheel here. We have a lot of different groups at many different levels doing economic development work. so we're not out there trying to be another spoke in the wheel. We take their information, we go out and survey public agencies, the cities, the special purpose districts, the schools, universities, human service agencies, a wide range of groups, and get their priorities for economic development to fit within EDA's framework. We put that together in a compilation document. We put it back out to everybody so they have something to reference. And sometimes it does help build partnerships. You see what one city is doing or another special purpose district is doing, and you see a relation to that with something you want to do, and you're able to build that partnership as you move along. We did, when we did the document, 2007 survey, over 200 groups within the upstate, over 30 here in Spartanburg County. We go back out as part of this update, survey them again. We ask for an update on the progress of projects that have already been put into the plan. We also ask, provide an opportunity for including new projects in the plan that have been identified. In this case, there were 40 projects added this year to make our total 90 for the five-year planning period we have. We started out with 48, so we've added almost as many projects as we started out with. There's been about 20 completed since 2007. The majority of all projects are sewer transportation. They make up about 70% of all projects that have been submitted. We have 8 additional projects underway, and lots of different things. They range everywhere from downtown projects, like in City of Woodruff, where they've just renovated the old schoolhouse to be their town hall as part of a larger downtown revitalization effort, to sewer and water projects throughout trying to support economic development. We've spoken to all the groups and staff throughout the county. This is really our opportunity to get before county council. We do ask county councils to endorse their section of the SEDS document before we take it to our board of directors and before we send it into EDA. So this is our opportunity to get your feedback if there's anything you see in there that you'd like to see included or is missing along those lines before we ask for your endorsement.
Do we have a motion that we concur with this report from Mr. Bentley?
So moved.
Motion made and seconded. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
We'll recommend full council concurrence.
Thank you very much.
Thank you for your presentation.
Mr. Chairman, is there any reason for Mr. Bentley to stay on?
Well, I don't think so. Any of the council members have any questions? Feedback, legal truck?
Sure. Thank you, Mr. Hall.
Spartanburg truck. Mr. Chairman, that concludes our meeting.
Thank you, Mr. Britt. Your live is under public account. So it's personnel and finance. With Dale covered, Chairman.
Chairman, we have a couple of couple items come before our committee today. First, you receive information, take desired action in reference to a resolution amending the scope of the CIP project PR0011 North Spartanburg Sports Complex to include the addition of a fully accessible playground unit and authorized transfer of funds related thereto. Mr. Tim Campbell is going to talk to us about this.
Yes, this is an excellent project. It's something that's sort of a cleanup from the Parks Commission who allocated $50,000 to the Carolina Miracle League, and of course then the Parks Commission was subsequently dissolved. This is a very worthwhile project for Spartanburg County, and the partnership with the Miracle League has been an excellent partnership. Ms. Pam D is here if you'd like to ask her any specific questions, but I will tell you Spartanburg County is very lucky to have a citizens group of the caliber of the Miracle League to work with us in providing accessible recreation to children.
I think I'm under the understanding that this originally started as kind of like a match funds, and I think you guys went way above. Can you elaborate on that a little bit, please?
Yes. This is a $200,000 project, and your $50,000 will round out the money. So we have raised $150,000 to do this. This will be the only park for special needs children in Spartanburg County. It's time for one, I believe. And putting it at the field, which is also for special needs children, it makes it a destination for our special needs community.
I saw the schematics for it. It looks like it's going to be just beautiful.
We're excited about it. And we thank you for all y'all have done for us over the years.
Well, I just add that Miracle League likes to have volunteers to come out and help with the children. So any of you in the audience and any of us on council, maybe we should do a council night.
That would be fabulous.
Yes.
I can arrange that.
Out there.
I can arrange that. Thank you.
Any other questions?
Mr. Chairman, may I?
Yes, sir, you may.
Pam, if she wants to do a chairman's night, I'd be awful proud to have all these people out in the best county council district there. I'm awful proud of you having that quite the goddamn night.
This time, can I entertain a motion if we adopt this resolution?
I'll make a motion.
Second. Second, all those in favor, let the number raise your right hand. Next item on our list is to receive information, take desired action in reference to a resolution for Tiger River Park funding package. And again, we have Mr. Jim Campbell, sir.
What this does is take the list of what we turn to the county administrator of our wants and needs, and it funds everything. To the tune of auto, around $17.4 million. This will essentially complete Tiger River Park, with the exception of two small items that we are going to be doing some further research on that will be related to making the park more comfortable in the hot summer, some cooling devices and some shade. But what we're asking you to do is to transfer this money from another COPS approved project under the certificate participation program that was done in 2009. And so this will complete Tiger River Park and will allow us to buy the remainder of the equipment that is needed to open the park for the first tournament, which is September 30th, 2011. And after the vote, I have a further request of y'all.
Mr. Chairman, I make a motion to accept.
Have a motion, have a second.
Second. Mr. Chairman, can I?
Yes, sir, you sure to make.
Jim, I'm concerned about this transfer. I have been, I guess we've talked about it. And I understand that it needs to be done, and I was wondering if you could explain a little bit about the need and why this needs to be done at this time and why this money is available for 15-20. That's the money we're currently talking about. And if you could answer another question for me about the roughly 400 and something thousand in the trail development fund. That is a very special project for, especially in my district, and that money, everybody worked hard for all that money that was provided there. And I have a lot of trouble myself moving that money because it's kind of a symptom of some things that have happened along the last couple of years where we're really have put ourselves in a position where we almost have to make this transfer in order for this regional park to be continued, but to the detriment of our trail system that so many people have worked so hard for. So if you could explain that a little bit before they vote on this.
Well, the difficulty is the trail portion that was being talked about went along the riverfront. And quite frankly, I'm hoping, again, I'm still getting my Spartanburg landmark straightened out.
Tiger River used to cover just about the whole county.
Yeah.
A bunch of Tiger Rivers.
The problem with it is that virtually no work has been done on the development of that trail to this day. And we've got to spend that money before October 1st, 2012. As we've looked at it, it's virtually impossible to spend that trail's money by that date. First of all, with land acquisition issues that we know will be there. And also, we're going to have some regulatory issues associated with it being a riverfront trail. So what we're basically doing